Backstage, O2.
To be the player who, you know, makes the crowd have some kind of experience.
What's up? How you doing, man? I see you doing the video. That's cool. Good to see you guys.
So another trick of the trade is always reach out to these brands, the type of gear you like to play. Reach out, figure out who these guys are, the artist reps, write an email. They want to hear from you. You know, we're in business together. Steady, are you ready?
Ready,
are you ready?
What's going on?
What's going on? What's up, guys? This is Drew DeCaro, another Drutorial. Today we're gonna do Coffee by Miguel.
I gone to tongue kiss it, but we're bad to be daring. Would you rather a cold flame, but feeling no shame? Drugs, sex, and Polaroid.
So coffee starts with the tonic, first chord.
Wish I could
a little intro. F sharp major to what is A sharp minor. The how you call chords in F sharp becomes a little bit of a pain in the neck, but there it is. There it is. Second phrase, do this little triplet thing. Right? And all that is G sharp, A, A sharp.
Bye, baby. I wish I could paint. These moments in
B section goes B major. It's the four chord. To C sharp major. It's the five chord. Back to B major. And then the little riff. Okay? That's a lot, but we will break it down. So now we get to the verse. The verse is F sharp to the sixth chord, which is D sharp, back to the F sharp, to the five chord, which is C sharp, now to the four chord. We're in the pre-chorus again. Five chord, we're gonna go back to the B, which is the four chord, and we're gonna play that little riff. To the top, to our A sharp. I know it's coming fast, but I will break it down to our triplet. If you know the song, you know this part. To our B, to our C sharp. We're gonna play the riff and then we're playing the chorus. Here comes the riff and the hook. Now the hook is a pain in the ass for sure, but check it out. I'll walk you through it. Does that make sense so far? We do this. Right? Then we do the turnaround. Okay, then we go to the verse. Still F sharpy. To a D sharp. F sharp, F sharp. To the C sharp. Then back to this turnaround, which we already did. Now, if you haven't ever heard the song, none of this will make any sense, but if you're well, you know, familiarized with the tune, then hopefully all of this totally is easy.
Wow.
wish I could pay our love's moments. Sweet dreams turn into fucking in the morning. Yeah. We talk sweet.
So do a riff and we go to the hook. What that riff is, by the way, is thirds. You're basically playing down the scale in thirds, which is something that is a cool way to sort of just practice guitar, doing, you know. Right? More or less, that's what's happening. So you go down a third, down a third. Again, it looks like a mess, but this is something that everybody who's ever practiced piano or practiced sax or practiced, you know, whatever your sort of classical training is, they've done a lot, spent a lot of time doing that. Talking about it's annoying. I don't really want to talk about it. I'd rather just play it. You guys hear it. You should know. Everybody's heard that sound. So just know those are thirds and go ahead and work it out for yourself. And that's exactly what's happening in this riff. Okay, cool. So you guys got that. The chorus goes like this. What's happening there? Basically, that's a one chord to a five chord, the most traveled chord progression in all of Western music. It's one to five. In this case, F sharp to C sharp. But what's happening on the C sharp, and this is about to get heady, so just follow me, is it's a C sharp in first inversion, meaning we don't play C sharp as the root. What we play as the root is third, there's that term again, the third of C sharp, which is in this case F natural or E sharp. Well, I'm not gonna bother you with that. Let's just call it F natural. Again, playing songs in F sharp major is a pain in the neck, so sorry to throw all that stuff by you guys so quick. So what you're having here is F sharp and effectively C sharp, but we're not playing C sharp in the root, we're playing F in the root. And so that chord looks like this. Right? That's your C sharp, it's basically a C that you know. Bring that up a half step, that's how we make it C sharp. C sharp. And then if you play this low note right here, you're getting the third of the C sharp. This is called a slash chord. It's pretty advanced harmonically. It's not something that you're gonna find in like most of your tunes, but is a really hip way to sort of take harmony to like your next level, slash chords. So we'll dig into that in further tutorials, but that's what's happening here. F sharp major to C sharp over F, or C sharp over E sharp. Takes a lot of finger strength. The reason it's cool is because the bass line has that little half step movement, and the bass has like just, you know, when you're playing neighboring tones like that, then it's cool because you start to develop a line as opposed to playing up the fifth, which is what the bass player could do. That's cool. It's a little more pop punk than this, which is a little more secretive, a little more secret agent vibe. So that's what's happening. Second half of the chorus, we walk down to the sixth chord, D sharp. We walk down to the five chord, C sharp. We go to the three chord, B flat, then the four chord.
And I like this, darling. Oh, souls have found a new religion. Now I'm swimming in that sin. A bastard. Peace to the skies above.
It's like you're looking at it through a microscope.
I know, right?
Little band! The little band!
It's a little petri dish.
No, see, nah.
Chorus, one more time. We're gonna go one to the 5 chord in first inversion, right? Then you can go to the 6 chord, which is D sharp minor. The 5 chord, which is C sharp major. The 3 chord, which is B flat minor or A sharp minor, to the 4 chord, B major. It's a lot going on, but we're really just using just those 5 chords the entire song. So it's just a matter, again, of the arrangement that you put those chords in that then can sort of give you support for what is really the important part, which is the melody and the song. Okay, that's mostly it. So let's do it again. And I'll play all the way through the first half of the song, and then I'll give you a couple little tricks for how to make it come alive on acoustic guitar. Okay. Tricks that I'll throw you and then we'll be done is I threw that one color chord in there at the top. You know I gotta sneak something like that in there. This is F sharp add 4. It's the one time we can use an open string, which is the B natural. So you got an F sharp major bar chord, and what you're gonna do is you're going to lift your finger off the B string. But how do you do that? Because you're barring every single string. Well, this is what you do. You take this first finger, hold down the F sharp on the high E string. You're gonna take your thumb back here, hold down the F sharp on the low E string, and now you've got your open B string. See how that happened? So instead of barring these three, I'm now doing this, and I'm leaving the B string open. I'm keeping these three fingers where they were. Okay? Again, it's a mouthful, but what you're getting now is a little bit of this cascading quality where the B and the B flat sort of play nicely together. And then you hit. So I like to do that a lot whenever I'm doing something in F sharp major, is that chord right there. So there's your choice Drew chord for this episode. And then this what is the pre-chorus? The gun, wordplay turns into gunplay, gunplay turns into pillow talk. The cool little thing that I do on that one is there is like this synth happening up top that's playing A sharp. That's like happy, it's like a piano or something. Some weird sound thing that happened. I like to play it on the guitar. I bring it down an octave. And so now I play that B flat right there. And I keep it. It's the major 7 of this B chord. And then it becomes the 6 of this chord. So that's a little bit of a handful, but it's cool. It provides you to have low chordal movement, but to have this note up above it that is staying static. And to me, that is like the cool juxtaposition. That's the vibe I'm going for. So I'm gonna play. Say I play this power chord with these fingers, and that way I leave my first finger open to play that B flat. That's what I'm thinking there, although it's kind of subconscious, but that's what's happening. So. So that is what that is. I'm sort of always reaching for stuff like that, a way to have the low move, the chords moving, but then something like static and ostinato up top, because that is just colorful to me. Or the opposite, have a chord staying the same and have a line moving up top, which if you guys checked out the Waves Drutorial, I did something like that, where we have A just staying the same, but there is a moving line. So that is kind of fundamentally what's happening behind that. All right, cool. The one thing I was gonna promise you guys is how to do it in F. So let me try to squeeze this in here before it gets too long. So that's everything in F sharp, a lot going on, but effectively just 5 chords, just knowing how to play them and how to bring these parts alive with our right hand. We're always talking about that. Let's bring the whole thing down a half step. And for those of you who, your hand's cramping up, this is a way to do that. So, F sharp, or F, excuse me, up to A minor. Could take it easy on that one. Still a triplet. Now. See how you can have open strings now because of the key we're in? Would be C, but with the open E. Okay? I'm gonna tab this out for you guys because it's a lot going on, but I believe in you.
Coffee in the morning, 'cause I don't wanna wake you. I just wanna watch you sleep.
D minor.
It's the smell of your
I think that's all for now. That's Coffee by Miguel. It's in F sharp major, which is a hard key. I do implore you to practice that. It's good to get that hand strength with all of these bar chords. But if you're more concerned with singing well and you don't want to trip on the guitar, which is arguably what you should be more concerned with, then bring it back a half step, do it in F, and then you get some open cowboy chords and you can sort of take a breather. And that's that. We learned a new chord. This is F sharp major 7 add 4, I think is what you'd call this. And we also learned about how to keep an ostinato note up top. That just means one note playing again and again and again while the chord moves below it. Coffee by Miguel. I'm Drew DeCaro. This is a Drutorial. Good luck with all that. Next time.